Wow, what a show out there for Midnight Madness. You know, to the casual fan, championships are won with a combination of talent, hard work, and character. But nowadays, if you were to ask players and staff where the road to a championship begins, they're going to tell you right here in the weight room.
Well, our program is based on three main goals that we look to achieve. Our first goal is injury reduction.
I mean, if you don't put the time in the weight room, I mean, that can cause injuries. And basically, players can, you know, make you do what they want them to do.
It's such a big part of the game now. You know, if you're not in shape, you're not going to be great on the ice.
Our second goal is to make these kids better athletes. Right, my job is not to make them a better hockey player, make them a better basketball player. The big thing is to try to make them better athletes so we can put them in a better position to make a play.
If you don't have the strength and conditioning, you can't last a 30-game season. Like, you want to be playing in March.
And the last goal that we look to achieve is education, because we want to educate them about why we do what we do, educate them about nutrition, educate them about supplementation, educate them about their sleeping habits, managing their stress.
It creates a good atmosphere, not only in the gym, but on the playing field as well.
The upperclassmen realize the commitment in the weight room will pay off, but sometimes it's a tough lesson for the freshman student athlete.
That freshman year, you know, coming in is tough because you just don't know what to expect. And once you've been here for a year, you know, you've been here with the guys and learning from them and from Coach B, you know what to expect.
I mean, with the freshmen coming in, sometimes they don't think that they have to lift weights, but that first scrimmage or that first practice, I mean, it helps them a lot.
It's pretty cool to see the freshmen integrate this year because they've jumped on board because of our upperclassmen and what we did last year.
You come to the rink every day, not only to go on the ice or you know, playing field, but you come together, you bond together in the gym, you push each other, and that's what we want. That's the type of atmosphere any collegiate team wants.
I just don't want them to be healthy when they're here, but I'm trying to give them the tools so they know how to lead a healthy lifestyle even when they're done with their career here at Quinnipiac.
Yeah, Coach B, you know, he's a little guy, but, you know, he makes us work hard. He gets his point across, because if you don't listen to him, you got some consequences. I know firsthand, so.
So the most satisfying part about my job is not only to see them play and see how what we've done in the offseason affects them and how they're going to perform differently and how they've become more athletic, but the biggest thing is having an impact, hopefully, on their life.
Well, I tell you what, partner, I don't think people understand the commitment it takes not only on the court, but off the court in order to be successful.
Well, for now, that's going to wrap things up from Quinnipiac University. Well, wait a minute. I thought Jamie was going to join us.
Yeah, where is Jamie?
Hey, guys. How are you?
Hey, Jamie.
Hi, Jamie.
Wow, this campus is beautiful.
It really is, isn't it?
Oh, I love it.
Jamie's going to be joining us for our Quinnipiac basketball broadcast here on Nesson. Welcome to the team, Jamie.
Thank you, Bill. I can't wait. It's going to be so exciting.
Jamie, you play hoops?
Mecca, do I play? I think I can show you a few things.
Oh, we got to see about that.
But before I do teach Billy the finer points of basketball, I want to thank all of you for joining us on Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. And be sure to join us for the upcoming Quinnipiac games right here on Nesson. Now, Billy, I'm going to show you how to slam
dunk. Oh, let's do this. Come on.